Mrs. Allison's cancelled her school run. Her little boy has got something wrong with him.
Taken her long enough to find that out, hasn't it?
Yeah. This must be your most favourite part of the day, Sam. To see the night crew going home and the real drivers coming on duty.
Bunch of tossers, you mean. See ya, losers. I'm off home. To bed.
Here, Ollie.
Do you want to borrow this magazine?
Barry, even the pages of your Radio Times stick together.
You're an early Basil. So it's a day off. New rotor at the sorting office. Do you want a coffee? Look, I thought you could do with one.
Yeah, well, no, I was in the recording studio till about 3 this morning.
What, you making a record?
Yeah. Well, sort of demo.
How much that cost then?
Well, it's not cheap, but I'm earning, so I thought, go for it.
Yeah, good for you. Do you want an hobnob?
Hey, oh, no, I'm going to pop home in a minute and get some breakfast.
Oh. All right. Bye, everyone.
Hello.
Hurry up and go, will you, Barry? I'm allergic to cats.
What did he say?
Take it easy, Marilyn.
You fart brain, Barry. My Bob bought me this, and it's not cat. It's ocelot.
What I'm saying, Marilyn, is I'm allergic to fur.
I'll punch your lights out one of these days, you little dribbler. I'll see you this evening.
See you, Marilyn.
Have a nice rest.
Chris the cabs.
Why do you have to go around Marilyn's cage?
I said that in all innocence, Sam. I am allergic to animals. I went down my brother-in-law's shop, you know, down the high street. Pets Forever. He's got dogs, cats, rabbits. I did nothing but sneeze. He's got crocodiles. He's got a dirty great snake, 8 feet long. Even a snake made me sneeze.
The snake made you sneeze. This is what happens when cousins marry.
Phil, job for you. Someone called Terry Connolly wants to go from his office to Wilton Town Hall. Ask for you personally. Is he a friend?
Kind of. Well, actually, Terry's my show business agent.
I didn't know you had an agent.
Oh, yeah. Get nowhere in the modern music world without a good agent.
How long have you been with him, then?
Oh, about 9 years. I'll give you a call when I'm clear.
Barry, I don't want to go on about it, but you do not want to wind Marilyn up. She starts foaming at the mouth and effing and blinding at the drop of a hat.
That woman's had obscene phone callers hang up on her. When she goes into one, she makes Hitler look like a yes man. Right! Keep an eye on the clock. This is a minicab office. It's a Brent Cross sales, so it's going to be a busy day. And remember, if your wheels are turning, you know you're earning. Let that be your mantra.
New Age Talent Agency, Naomi speaking. How may I help you?
You go to baby school.
Phil, where are you?
I'm on a call.
Hold on.
In crying, baby.
Cher, Madonna, go and get your things ready for school. If you two keep arguing, I won't let you stay up late tomorrow and watch Daddy get drunk. I thought you were coming home for breakfast.
No, I've got a busy day. I'm going straight onto the Rose and Crown tonight. I've got my stage gear in the boot. Are you coming down there?
You know, like you do sometimes.
Might.
Yeah?
Yeah.
With a little red number.
I said might. And be quiet, someone might be listening to the call.
Well, guarantee the Rose and Crown a big audience then, wouldn't it? Look, I'll see you later then.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, has my speaker come back yet?
What speaker?
Well, one I sent away for repair about 3 weeks ago. But it was warping the sound.
It wasn't warping the sound, Phil. It was your voice.
No, it was warping. They said they'd deliver it.
Well, nothing's arrived. You can take a shopping tomorrow and pick it up yourself. It'll save on
delivery charge.
No, it's Saturday tomorrow. I work Saturdays.
Oh, yeah. You work the last 5 or 6 Saturdays. Never used to work on a Saturday. Always too tired after Friday night.
Yeah.
I mean singing.
I know, but I'm forcing myself to work Saturday afternoons
now and bring some extra money in.
Oh, where is it?
What?
With this extra money.
Yeah.
What? If that woman from the VAT office phones, I'm still in hospital.
Yeah.
Look, I've got to go. My customer's here.
Put that phone down. Come on.
Yeah. No.
How's it going, Tel?
Oh, not too bad. Not too good. I've known it better. It's been a hell of a lot worse. Opportunities present themselves and then they become overshadowed by disaster. What's the word for that?
Bollocks.
Show business. That's the word.
So, how's things with you, young?
All right, I suppose.
You know, I'm recording a few of my own songs down at Graham's studio. Well, he said he was doing us a favour. I mean, I knew I'd drop him a few quid to pay his expenses and that. But he's brought in session singers, professional guitarists. He's even brought his cousin in as an arranger. He's coming to a bloody fortune, working all hours to pay it.
Well, if you don't buy a ticket, you won't win the raffle, will you?
Nah, I suppose you're right. So what are you up to? Anything exciting?
Whoa, exciting's the wrong word, Philip. I'm at the moment organising a talent contest to end all talent contests. Huey Green will be turning in his grave. I'm putting it on at the Civic Centre, an extravaganza. I'm going to put Wilston on the map, as they say.
Well, how much does the winner get?
Note.
Oh, it's tempting.
Well, at least nothing financially, but career-wise, the sky's the limit. I've got this deal with a very influential TV producer, who's promised the winner a TV shot. 5 minutes nationwide exposure. I don't know what show yet, Lee. Could be Richard and Judy, maybe Pebble Mill at one, even the Des O'Connor show. Chance of a lifetime.
And me and the band be playing, innit?
No, you're not listening, Philip. I said talent contest.
Don't smile, Basil. I want natural.
Sorry.
Coffee soon.
Same. You all right?
Yeah. Come on.
I've got an exhibition coming up in a few weeks, and I'm trying to capture the state of humanity.
So no pictures of Barry, then?
No-ho! Oh, that's almost funny, Cambridge. You know, if you tried harder, you could be mildly amusing. I still haven't figured out what you're doing here. This used to be an occupation for working-class men before you ponces from the university took our jobs. Anyway, I thought someone that left Cambridge went straight on the television with Rowan Atkinson and all them puffs.
Actually, Barry, I didn't go to Cambridge University. I went to Bristol. And I had other things in mind other than going on telly with Rowan.
Takes me back.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter whether it was Cambridge or Bristol.
You and Muriel had a lovely wedding. What about that party afterwards?
Yeah. It was something, wasn't it? What was it Dexter called it? The Four Dog Swingers.
Yeah, that was Dexter.
Yeah, I sometimes look at that old video of me and Mer's anniversary dinner. Right, just to remind me of good times. Funny how it all changes so quickly, innit? I wonder what mate has got decides you've had too much happiness.
Hey, come on.
Yeah. I'm gonna go and get some air.
Hey, I was talking to the manager of the Rose and Crown, and he reckons that every Friday night, this groupie-type tart comes in, miniskirt, you know, high heels, legs up to her neck, and you pull her every Friday.
No, it's not tart. It's Chrissy.
Chrissy? What? You're Chrissy?
Yeah. Look, keep this to yourself, right? It's a game we play, sort of fantasy. She dresses up in all the gear and comes down the pub. We pretend we never met. Then we sort of chat each other up and... well, sort of... in the back seat of my car. That's perfectly normal.
Yes, if you happen to be the Marcus to see it.
Well, look, don't mention it to anyone, right? Anyway, why are you talking to the governor of the Rose and Crown?
Well, I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad tidings, Philip, but he's cancelled your gig.
Cancelled it? Already? I thought we went down well with the audience.
Yes, but the Titanic went down well with the Atlantic.
Well, that's your fault. You should get us a booking at a venue where our style of music would be appreciated.
Well, when I open the Albanian office, I'll let you know. Look, man, I'm just having a joke with you, you know? No, it's just that your style hasn't found its niche yet.
Well, you should get off your arse and go around a few clubs and find us the right place. I pay you,
really. All right, I will manage, just I've got more pressing problems at the moment. You know I manage Medusa, Queen of the Snakes. She's a... exotic dancer.
Sort of. Oh, yeah, I saw a photo of her back at your office. What, stripper?
Ooh, and some. Well, her gimmick is, you see, she has a snake wrapped around her neck, hence Medusa, Queen of the Snakes. See, the snake's part of the act. She, well, the snake's important, like, you know what I mean?
Oh, right. What, is she in the talent contest?
No, no, for God's sake, man. Can you imagine that on the Des O'Connor show? God knows what Richard and Julie would think of her. No. She's definitely not mainstream.
So what's the problem?
Our snake's died. She's got this big gig Saturday night, a police piss-up. 300 CID officers. She kind of developed a new act in time, you see? I mean, stripping isn't just a case of taking your clothes off, you know? Look the way she does it anyway. Problem is, you can't get a snake these days for love nor money. It's all these new rules, endangered species, all that bollocks. Bloody Rolf Harris, man.
A snake? Now, I might be able to help you, Tell.
What, you've got a snake, man?
No, but I know what I can get you one. It's a mate of mine at work's brother-in-law's got one in his shop.
It's not poisonous, is it?
No, I don't think so.
Ooh, had an incident a couple of years ago, very nasty. Tell you what, you'll try explaining that on your way into casualty.
No, this is a big snake, you know, 8 foot long. They're not the poisonous ones, are they?
Oh, that's right, that's what we're after, a boa or a python. There'll be no questions asked.
Not with this bloke. When do you want it by?
Tomorrow night.
Tomorrow? I don't give it much time to train it, does it?
Train it? Hey, she doesn't send it to drama school, you know.
Yeah, but it's got to be kept under control, isn't it?
No, well, Medusa, you see, she keeps it in a cool place. You keep them cold, it makes them go to sleep.
I never knew that.
Oh, yeah, you keep them chilly, they'll sleep forever. Then an hour before the performance, she warms the snake up, sprinkles a couple of Valium over a mouse.
Mouse?
Snake eats the mouse, becomes all docile. That's your business. Right, listen. There's 100 for the snake, and there'll be 100 in it for you.
Well, thanks, Tell. It'll pay off some of my studio costs. What I really wanted was an opportunity.
Yeah, well, you'll do this for me, I'll put you in the talent contest.
Yeah? Brilliant. There you go. That'll be £4.50.
What do you mean?
Barry, why do you involve yourself in intellectual debate? You have the mental age of a professional footballer.
What did you actually study, Cambridge? Greek mythology? Well, what a waste of taxpayers' money that is. There's a lot of call for Greek mythologists these days, isn't there? You see ads all over the job centre. Wanted, Greek mythologer. Company car, good pay, moussaka on a Friday. What a joke. It's like Einstein, isn't it?
What is, Barry?
Well, he invented that theory, what's it called?
Relativity.
That's it. That's what everyone says. Here, you're a genius. You invented the theory of relativity. Well, at the end of the day, it's only a theory, isn't it?
Is this for real?
I'm afraid it is.
No, I've got to admit, Barry's got a point. I mean, practical's the only thing that counts, isn't it? I mean, all the theories in the world aren't going to get your brake pads changed, are they?
Exactly. And talking of brake pads, here, Sam, my brother-in-laws want your car back in their garage. That spare's coming.
You mean I can't have my car for the weekend again?
They only have one delivery of spares a week, Sam, and that's on a Friday. That's why they work on your car at the weekends.
Yeah, but they've had my car for the last 6 weekends on the trot.
Exactly. That's why they're prepared to work Saturdays and Sundays. They're perfectionists.
I don't believe it. Tell them I want it back first thing Monday morning.
Roger, Roger.
Good morning, everyone.
What's the traffic like, Henry?
Oh, it's chocolate box.
Chock-a-block.
Oh, yes, especially around the Elephant and Castle.
What were you doing around the Elephant and Castle, Cock?
That's what I would like to know, Sam.
But you were only supposed to go to Hammersmith.
But it's one-way systems and diversions.
Well, you did drop your passengers off.
Oh, yes, I dropped them off at the cab rank.
You dropped them off at a black cab rank?
Yes. I thought it might be quicker.
Barry, you were saying earlier your brother-in-law's got a snake in his shop.
Yeah, bloody big sod it is.
Will he sell it to me?
Sell it? What do you want a snake for?
I just need one urgently. Will he sell it?
Well, of course he will, but as it's an emergency snake, it'll be that little bit dearer.
It's all right. Here. There's 70 notes.
Keep the tenner for yourself.
Sweet. Right. I'll have a word with him.
I need it by tomorrow. Stay in touch.
Sorry doesn't cover this one, Phil. I have never been so humiliated, and don't make any stupid cracks about getting out more often. I was wearing red shoes and a red dress. I looked like Santa's bit on the side. There were men with ponytails, men in vests, men who think through their sweat glands were ogling me.
Well, in them clothes, they're bound to think...
Shut up! You don't have to be Paul McKenna to work out what all those wannabe Porsche drivers were thinking.
Sorry.
Why didn't you phone and tell me you'd been cancelled?
Well, I had so much on my mind, Chris, I just forgot.
So where were you? Down that stupid recording studio?
No, I wasn't. Well, I admit I popped in just to put some finishing touches to that song that I wrote for you.
Well, you shouldn't have wasted your time. I'm taking the kids out.
Where?
Anywhere, just anywhere. And your stupid speaker's been delivered. I've left it in the kitchen.
Thanks.
Come on, hurry up.
Where are we going?
Shopping.
Rin said you wanted me to call around.
Yeah. Shh. Come in. Someone asleep? Shh. So off.
Dear Lord, be with us in our hour of need. It's a snake!
I know it's snake.
That's why I called you over. When you're African, you must have seen these things before.
Yes, I have. I've never liked them. Terrible things.
He's asleep.
Well, stop going. It might hear you and think it's a mating call. Where did you catch it?
I didn't. I bought it off Barry. Do you know what kind of snake it is?
No, what?
No, I'm asking you. You and the Nigerian army, Henry, you and your mates must have come across these things.
Yes, we did, often.
Well, what did you do?
Run!
Marlon, I've just been shopping at Mr. Mahmood's supermarket and there's a job advertised in the window for a general assistant. I immediately thought of you. Put your best clothes on and we'll go and have a word with him later.
What, will I be in the army?
The army? Oh, no, not that kind of general. No, it means somebody who can, like, you know, kind of sweep up and that.
Yeah, I can do that, Bez. I used to be a sweeper for Manchester United.
Well, you mustn't tell Mr. Mahmood that sort of thing, man. Don't go telling him you were in the SAS or had an affair with posh spice.
Why not?
Well, he might think you're showing off. Well, keep that kind of thing just between you and me.
Yeah. Yeah, all right, Basil. I've never had a job before.
Yeah, well, you haven't got this one yet. And I want you to impress upon Mr. Mahmood that although you've had no experience, you're willing to learn.
I'm willing to learn.
That's right, Marlon, you're willing to learn.
I'm willing to learn.
Oh, good boy. Oh, so you've been practising your writing. Oh, that's very good. Yeah. Oh, you see there, look, you've written almost. You've put two L's. Well, you only need to put one L in almost.
Nah, that's all right, Basil. I've got loads of ink.
Right.
Now take your coats off and don't just leave them anywhere. Phil, just leave your old rubbish lying anywhere. The maid will clear it up.
Jaws lined with teeth make crocodiles just as formidable as a dragon should be.
Quick, hide. Someone's coming.
A snake!
It's okay. Don't worry. It's mine.
Yours?
So that's why I phoned you, Rajiv. Henry's been a waste of time.
What makes you think I know anything about snakes?
Well, you're Asian.
I was born in Slough. Phil, unless you got a mongoose handy, I can't help you. Why'd you get a snake in the first place?
Well, it's for one of my show business agent's clients. She's an exotic dancer and she uses the snake. Well, I won't go into detail.
Thank you.
And so say all of us.
Well, it wasn't meant to be delivered here. I thought Barry's brother-in-law would take it straight round my agents. But Barry's family happened to come from a long line of old English cretins.
But why'd you put it in the freezer?
To scare the crap out of me. I've gone to get the girl some chips and there's an anaconda staring at me.
Because I was told to keep it cool. Just left it in there too long. But I might not be dead, eh? Might be hibernating.
It didn't look like hibernation to me, Phil. What you had there was a python lolly.
Yeah, but you never know, Rajiv. That's why I'm throwing it out.
Phil, it's done.
Is this part of reptile welfare?
I wouldn't have thought so for one moment.
I hope the RSPCA doesn't find out about this.
It's not my fault.
You put it in the deep freeze and froze it, and now you put it in the microwave oven and baked it.
Not exactly what you'd call self-defense, Phil.
I'm gonna have to get another one.
Another snake?
Yeah, he wants to try it in breadcrumbs next time.
And where are you going to get another snake from?
You don't find these things laying around on the ground.
What am I going to do?
All right. Rain said you had problems.
Look, I cooked it.
You cooked it?
Well, I wasn't sure if it was dead.
Well, this seems to have done the trick. Oh, my God. What's it been eating?
I don't get this. You didn't know it was dead. Of course it's dead. It's stuffed. That's why there's horsehair sticking out of it.
Stuffed?
Yeah.
I thought you said you'd got it from your brother-in-law's pet shop.
It ain't a pet shop. That's why it's called Pets Forever. He's a taxidermist.
I wanted a live snake!
Well, you should have told me.
You mean this has been dead ever since your brother-in-law delivered it?
Yeah, he died of old age. He bought it a few days ago off a stripper, Medusa or something.
Medusa? But I bought this to replace her snake, which... Shit! And I phoned my agent and said, no problems, Tell. I've got the snake. He's called the search off. The show's tonight and I've got 5 hours to find a live snake!
Come with me.
You got an idea, Barry?
This might work. No, I'm not promising anything, but it might just work. I'm going to see my brother-in-law.
I don't want another stuffed snake!
No, my other brother-in-law.
Well, what am I going to do with this?
Oof. Broccoli? New potatoes? Only joking.
It's never going to work.
Look, have some faith, will you?
Well, Medusa didn't look happy, did she? I just took one look at it. She didn't look happy.
Look, fair do. She did look a bit concerned.
Concerned? She was screaming blue murder.
It'll just take a bit of getting used to, that's all.
Why'd you sell me a stuffed snake in the first place?
You're supposed to be a rock and roll star. I thought you wanted to make a pair of snakeskin boots or a belt for your guitar.
Ah, it's you two. Starsky and Crutch. I'm glad I got you both on your own. There's something I wanted to talk to you about. Sit yourself down, Philip. It's a shame your brothers-in-law have got my car for the weekend again. Tomorrow's a special day for me. Tomorrow's mine and Muriel's 10th anniversary. Yeah, I would have loved to have taken some flowers, driven out in my Jaguar. Do you know what really started me thinking about it? I saw this picture in a local paper. Here we go. Reminded me of our wedding. Don't they look happy?
Yeah. Yeah. Lovely photo.
My parents have obviously splashed out. Bridal car's a Jaguar. Brought back memories of my Jaguar that spent so long in your brother-in-law's garage. Very similar. Right down to the number plate. Do you see anything familiar about it? Philip? Have a look through this magnifying glass. Pay particular attention to the chauffeur. Remind you of anyone? Because if I didn't know better, I'd swear blind that was you.
Me? What would I be doing wearing a chauffeur's uniform in a bridal car?
Chauffeur in a bloody bridal car, that's what! That's what you've been doing, isn't it? You've set up a bridal service. You and your slimy brothers-in-law have been hiring my car out for weddings and this shitwit's been driving it. That's why I haven't had my car for the last 7 weekends. And they've been sending me bills. You've been providing the whole package. And I wonder who the lucky couple had to do their cabaret. Could it possibly have been, hey, hey, word of wankers?
That
is an outrageous accusation based on the flimsiest of circumstantial evidence.
Oh, do you think so? Well, I'm going to go down to that newspaper and I'm going to find out who that photographer is. I'm going to get all the information I need from... Andre!
Yes, boss?
Oh, hello, Mr. Mahmood.
Basil, nice to see you again. What can I do for you?
Well, actually, I'm inquiring about the job advertised in the window, a general assistant.
Really? But you work for the post office. Minicab as well. I didn't think you'd have time for another job.
Oh, it's not for me. It's for Marlon.
Marlon?
I'm willing to learn.
Oh, I'm not sure, Basil. Let me think about it,
I think he'd be an asset to your supermarket, Mr. Mahmood. I mean, he's an industrious lad given half a chance, and that's all he needs. Half a chance.
I'm willing to learn.
Marlon, he has hidden qualities. He's very proficient on a bike.
I was in the Olympic British cycling team.
Marlon. And he's very helpful. Oh, Marlon, that lady can't reach. He's very honest. He'd never knowingly cheat you out of a penny, Mr. Mahmood. And as he said himself, he's willing to learn and he's a hard worker. And he's very strong.
Then I saw this photograph in a local paper of a wedding. And lo and behold, there was my car. You'll never guess, Muriel. It transpires that Barry, you remember Barry? Oh, no one ever forgets Barry. And Philip, you know, a singer. We used to call him Bonio. And Andre, he'd been hiring out my car as a bridal limousine. Pretended I was angry with them. In fact, I sacked them for a while. But in a way, I admired their initiative. Your garden's looking lovely, Muriel. I wish you could see it. I picked these this morning.
Everywhere I go, there are cars.
I've got some bad news as well, Mer. It's Dexter. Remember Dexter? My business partner.
I keep telling them to be careful.
Well, sadly, Dexter passed on a few weeks back. Left me in a spot of financial bother. Been dipping his fingers in the till. Quite a few times. Well, he was very mixed up towards the end. The sad thing is, 50% of it was his anyway. So he was just stealing from himself, really. Well, that's life. Or death. Whatever.
Headlines on my wall, big headlines. Cars, be careful.
I'm always careful, darling.
People keep coming in my room. They walk in and out, it's like a railway station.
Well, I think they need to take you back inside, darling.
I'm back again, Muriel. How's she seem today? More responsive?
Yeah.
Good. You see, At Muriel's age, she still has the occasional good day. I'm sure she enjoys your visits.
Well, bye-bye, darling. Happy anniversary.
What's he doing?
It's all right, Muriel. Calm down.
Who is that man?
It's your husband, Muriel. It's Sam.
I'll take her back inside now.
Yeah.
Tried to touch me. He was being friendly, Muriel.
Where are we going?
Okay, I'm taking you home now.
Till, I got your message.
Philip, how nice of you to join me. Hope I didn't drag you away from anything important, like digging your own grave.
Look, I heard what happened last night at the Civic Centre. I just came to say I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't pay me commission. Sorry doesn't take away the stain on me reputation. Last night, right, I ordered myself a minicab to get to the hall. I thought I'll have a nice night out with a few of me pals from the Metropolitan Police. I'm bound to want a drink. Only, I got there a bit late. Too late to save the day.
Should have used Chris the cabs.
I did. They sent me around a Nigerian chap called Henry. Nice enough bloke, only it took an hour and 5 minutes to do a 3-mile journey. He decided to take me on a shortcut via Cardiff. Anyway, as I arrived there, Medusa, Queen of the Snakes, was just entering the stage.
Yeah, look, tell
me. Just try and look at the picture, right, Philip? There's 300 steaming coppers. All clapping their hands, stamping their feet, all looking forward to a first-class evening of sleaze and filth set in clean and comfortable surroundings. In Medusa, the piers.
You see, things were getting a bit desperate.
In a look, in the coppers look, in plodding me, can't believe our eyes, because lo and behold, what does she have round her neck, Philip?
Yeah. You see, there wasn't enough time to phone you.
What did she have round her neck, Philip?
Well, I tried to phone you, but I couldn't get through.
What did she have round her neck, Philip?
Terry, you got to
understand. What did she have round her sodden neck, Philip?
An eel?
Yes! A great, big, long, slimy, bloody eel. And it escaped. There was mayhem in the hall. Last time I saw it, it was going down the drain in the gent's bog. It's the call of the ocean, you see. Sense of the water. They head straight for the sewers. No, the bastard's somewhere off the Hook of Holland.
Yeah, well, they're slippery. I told Medusa to keep a tight grip on it.
A tight grip on it? A tight grip? Look, she's a bloody stripper. What do you expect her to do? Come on stage with goalkeeper's gloves. Anyway, you left a message on my answer machine that you had a snake.
Yeah, but it was dead.
You were going to give Medusa a dead snake?
Well, I didn't realise at the time. So then Barry said that...
Barry, not Barry Carr, not that throwback of an excuse for a human being who once thought Yulu and Glazy was a window firm. You're not talking about him, are you?
Yeah. So he said his other brother-in-law might be able to help, so we went round to his shop.
Or a pet shop?
No, it's a pie and mash shop. That's where the eel came from.
I'll see you around, Philip.
Yeah. But tell... About the talent contest.
Mm-hmm.
No. Best forget it, eh?
Good idea. That's your business.
Thank you.
occasion of my wedding anniversary.
Right, and Muriel.
Yes, yes, and of course my darling wife, Muriel. Oi, oi, oi. We were married 8 years ago. June the 1st, 18... What? 19, sorry! 1986. Seven. I knew that. I was just testing you.
Drunk,
Sam. Oh, I am not. I am just intoxicated with joy and love.
That is the worst ever.
Alan, stop it. It was the loveliest day of my entire life. And I am surrounded here by Barry, keep that camera steady, zombie.
I'm not used to doing videos like this. Mine are a little bit more exciting, know what I mean? Go on, oi, Tina. Tina, give us a flash, love. Go on, get him out for the legs.
Stop it!
Barry, behave yourself, son. I will stick that camera right up your ass.
No, please, please. Now, I am surrounded here by good and loving friends.
Where, neighbour?
No, here for one. Here is my good and trusted business partner in business, Dexter Willis. Yes! And his fragrant, oh so fragrant wife, Tina.
Wait, that's her Charlie you can smell.
Oh, yes, thank you. Dexter and I started Questa Camps 1 year ago, and I am delighted to say that it has been a resounding success!
I'm sorry.
For what?
It's your anniversary today. Slipped my mind.
Oh, yeah. Completely forgot about it myself.
Tommy's gone up north. His mum's had a fall.
Yeah? Right, Marlon, get the plates on the table before the fish and chips go cold.
Leave it to me, Basil.
Basil. It's a letter from Mr. Mahmood at the supermarket. Hey, you've got the job.
What, I've got the job?
Yeah, you start tomorrow. Congratulations.
Thank you, Basil. Basil, does that mean I've got a career?
Oh, yeah, I suppose it does. Yeah, you've got a career, Marlon.
I haven't had a career since I was the British ambassador in Paris.
That's right. Well, let's celebrate. Put some music on. I think we should crack open a bottle of Guinness, don't you? Yeah. No,
you in autumn. So how was she today?
Same. Nothing changes. She didn't know who I was. This was Muriel's favourite musical.
I know.
Muriel loved musicals. If she'd had her way, the whole world would have been a musical. We'd all be walking around singing, "Oh, what a beautiful bloody morning." She's always playing music. Love songs. Barbra Streisand. Diana Ross. Night I come through that door, the music playing. Listen to this bit. And one night I came in and there was no music. She'd forgotten where the records were. I said, "It's a big cabinet, ma."
It's over there where it always is. She called herself a silly cow and we laughed about it. I wish I hadn't laughed.
Oh, you weren't to know, Sam.
That Don McLean song, American Pie, reminds me of that moment. The day the music died. When they said to me, it's Alzheimer's, I thought, oh, Alzheimer's, give you zombies. She's 40. You know what it's like. It's like my life's been fitted with a dimmer switch.
Sam, I don't have to go home tonight.
Good. Good.
Sam.
Yes, Miriam.